In this video, I am going to go over mounting the hydraulic oil cooler, the engine oil cooler, and engine oil filter here. I'm just going to go over some really quick fabrication. I'm not going to go into full detail, but I'm going to go over some of the reasoning why I mounted some of the stuff the way I did. So sit back and enjoy the video. So planning on installing the hydraulic oil cooler radiator, I decided I'm going to use this line, which is the return line of the oil filter, the hydraulic oil filter that goes to the tank. It returns to the tank. So this will be the lowest pressure line. So what I'm going to do is actually, instead of buying fittings and having hoses made to fit this, is I'm going to slice into this line and then put a barb with hose clamps on it, since this is such a low pressure line. And then I'm going to route the line down and across over here to above where the hydraulic pump is at. And this is the radiator core I'm going to use. And this is going to mount about here. And then in front of that, it's going to mount the oil cooler also. So I need to leave room for that. But to do this, I need to mount this physically to the machine. And what I'm going to do is just take some angle aluminum and cut it to length here, and then rivet it to the front of the machine on the bottom. And then I'm take another piece and rivet it across the top, facing like this way. That'll mount to the top holes. So let me go ahead and start getting cutting on those, get them set up, and we'll drill holes into this and rivet the angle iron to it, angle aluminum, and we'll go on from there. So I'm going to cut this bracket where the bottom of the radiator is going to sit and be bolted to. And this is the thing I love about aluminum. All you need is a good woodworking saw blade with carbide teeth on it, and you can cut aluminum anywhere you need to. And it cuts clean, so there we are. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and figure out where I want to mount this exactly, and then I'm gonna drill some holes in it and put it in the machine. All right, I finished the first of the four brackets that I'm gonna use to mount these radiators. I cut that one that I cut earlier in half, and then I've drilled four holes for the radiators to sit into. And then I drilled two holes into this to mount it to the inside of the machine. And that's about where it's gonna sit. So I'm just gonna rivet one side in and then drill the other hole through the machine, because I have one hole drilled through it now. I'm going to finish fabbing and drilling the other three brackets that the radiators are going to sit on, get those mounted in place, and then I'll catch you guys when I get the dry fit in place for the radiators. Oh, the joys of prototyping stuff. Anyways, so I was going to use the same angled aluminum material for all four mount points for the radiator, two bottom and two top points of each radiator. But, as you can see, I've changed to this flat piece here that has a short vertical, and it's got a really wide horizontal piece that I'm going to use. I vice gripped it in before I pop riveted in so I can get the alignment correct. The reason being is if you look down from the top, you can see there's an angle here. It's not parallel to this one. So, what I did is I just cut it to about the approximate length I needed, just took a vice grip and put it on here, and this stuck the two radiators. Let me stick it in here. Stuck the two radiators in here and manually aligned where I wanted this piece to be. And you can see, is lined up. Sorry about the camera angle. I'm trying to do this all with one hand, but I'm gonna be able to just barely get this back radiator mounted with this angle. And you can see it's in there nice. And then we'll get the rest of the brackets fabbed up and mounted. And I'll show you guys after I get these guys mounted in here. Okay, so this is what I ended up with for the mounts. I have this one mounted here, with four bolts going through here. And then I have the back piece that's mounted here, and there's four bolts going through there. And then I have the top one here, with four bolts going through it here. I have two rivets in this one, two in the one below it, and then three in this one that's on this back piece. So, haven't really decided if I'm gonna make a mount for this because it doesn't line up. I probably still will. Just gotta think about it. But I also, when I took these fittings off, I put some blue tape over it. So while I was drilling these holes, no metal shavings got down into these guys. So just a heads up there. Don't want any metal shavings in these two. All right, time to go to the next step. So this video was just gonna be about doing the hydraulic oil cooler, but I'm gonna do the hydraulic oil cooler, the mounting for the engine oil cooler, and then the mounting for the oil filter. So what I'm thinking about is I need to be able to get in here and get a good handhold on this guy. So I wanna put it about this height right here. And then the reason I also have, I'm gonna be mounting it this way, and these guys are vertical like this with the fittings at the top, is when the engine's off, I don't want all the fluid that's in these items, the filters and the two radiators, to drop back down the hydraulic fluid into the hydraulic tank, because I don't want it to overflow. And then I don't want to fill the engine crankcase with oil. So the only oil that should go back into the engine, if it does go back, is in the lines, which shouldn't be more than a couple ounces. So anyways, that's my thought process here, and moving on. Okay, I kind of got it mounted where I wanted it. I did mount it a little lower than where I was planning it. The oil filter is just a little bit below the edge of this, but the reason for that is because I wanted this bracket L here to actually help reinforce the other bracket the radiator's sitting on. So I'd prefer that being reinforced over the oil filter being easier to grab. I can still grab it here. I can undo it. So that's okay. I think on the next video, I'm going to do the fan video, because I need to build a shroud around this to make sure the air flows and gets sucked out through these radiators properly. So let's see. This fitting here, I think I'm going to replace with a 90 degree fitting so that the hose goes down better. I just ordered that on Amazon today, so that's going to be a couple days before that's in. Also, these Fram oil filters that I'm using here, the ToughGuard 3614, these fit my Briggs & Stratton riding mower engines. So I'm going to use the same filter on this engine, because that way I have to keep the same type of filters in stock here when I'm doing maintenance on the lawnmowers or on the mini excavator. So let's see. I think that covers everything I wanted to cover in this video today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked it, hit that thumbs up. If you want to see more of these videos, hit that subscribe button if you haven't subscribed yet. I really appreciate you watching the videos, and thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys on the next one.